What's going on, guys? My name is Keizo, and welcome back to part 2 of Dragon Age Origins. In the last video, we started out this character. We went through the intro movie, we grabbed a quest, or 6, and we're about to head out the door after we check our codex out. So let's go ahead and open our journal. We've got a tip here that says your journal tracks updates to your current objectives and records the results of prior exploits. This includes quests completed as well as codex entries that describe the world around you. At the bottom of your journal screen, the Make Active button lets you designate the quest you're currently working on, which activates arrows on the map and in the game world that direct you to the next point in the plot. So these are our quests here. Culture and history, we've got 2. One is of the city elves, which I am a city elf, so we'll read that. The humans tell tales of Andrast, and to them she was a prophet. To our people, however, she was an inspiration. Her rebellion against Teventer gave our people a window through which to see the sun, and we reached towards it with all our strength. The rebellion was brief but successful. Even after the death of the prophetess, we fought on for independence as human imperium began to crumble. In the end, we won freedom and the southern land known as the Dales, and we began the long walk to our new homeland. There in the Dales, our people revived the last lore as best we could. We called the first city Halamshiral, the end of the journey, and founded a new nation, isolated as elves were meant to be. This time patrolled by an order of Emerald Knights charged with watching the borders for trouble from humans. But you already know that something went wrong. A small elven raiding party attacked the nearby human village of Red Crossing, an act of anger that prompted the Chantry to retaliate, and with their superior numbers conquer the Dales. We are not enslaved as we had been before, but our worship of the ancient gods was now forbidden. We're allowed to live amongst the humans only as second-class citizens who worship their maker, forgetting once more the scraps of lore we had maintained through the centuries. The rise and fall of the Dales is told by Seritha, Harren of the Hyeber alienage. Alienage culture? There have always been alienages. They have been around for as long as elves and shems. What? And shems have lived in the same lands. Not quite more sure what Shems are. Ours isn't even the worst. They say that Val Royeaux has 10,000 elves living in a space no bigger than Dinarim's market. Their walls are supposedly so high that daylight doesn't reach the Venadal until midday. But don't be so anxious to start tearing down the walls and picking fights with the guards. They keep out more than keep in. We don't have to live here, you know. Sometimes a family gets a good break and they buy a house on the docks or the outskirts of town. If they're lucky, they come back to the alienage after the looters have burned their house down. The unlucky ones just go out to Pauper's Field. Here we're among family, we look out for each other. Here we do what we can to remember the old ways, the flat ears who have gone out there. They're stuck. They'll never be human. And they've gone and thrown away being elven too, so where does that leave them? Nowhere. And we've got our notes here. Feast day of gifts credits. Feast day of pranks credits. That, and we'll close this, and we'll head outside.
As you wish.
As you wish. As I wish, because that was me, technically. Alright, saving game, and we are in the alienage. Hooray. Not quite sure where we've got to go. That's home.
There once was a woman, she lived in the sea.
Okay.
Me. I brought her diamonds, rubies, silver, and gold. but all she wanted was to be saved from the cold. She begged me to catch her, convinced me I should. I promised her a house, all gray stone and wood. We made love in the sea. We made love on the shore. I was just there for playing, but she wanted more. But there's one small problem, you see. I can't grant her wish. My wife gets suspicious when I come home smelling like fish.
Wow. Wow. All right. Yeah. Well, I'll right click to examine.
This should be easy enough.
Right. Do we just jump over the wall? Apparently we just jump over the wall. Or do we not jump over the wall? Maybe we go the opposite way. Right, let's go this way.
Well, it's around the eyes, mostly.
I still don't see it. Whenever I look, I just see the mother.
The mother was far more delicate.
It's the same sort of nose, you must admit that. The breeding shows.
Well, there you go again with breeding. We're not horses, you know.
Of course not, but bloodlines are important, that's all I'm saying.
I think the whole notion is ridiculous.
Well, you've got the thing to
see. The plot marker.
Well, if it isn't my lucky cousin. Care to celebrate the end of our independence together?
Getting cold feet, Soros?
Are you surprised? Apparently your bride's a dream come true. Mine sounds like a dying mouse.
I'm sure she's quite nice.
Great. I'll spend the next 50 years with a nice girl who hides grain away for the winter. Let's go introduce you to your dreamy betrothed before you say I do.
Alright. Controlling party members. A new party member has joined you. You can take control of this character directly by left-clicking on his or her portrait or left-clicking on the character. See, this is cool. I can control... There I am, now my party member. Let's see what we got here. He is a warrior. I like that. And another nice thing in this game is this. Let's see. I'll go ahead and tell him to move there, and I'll move there. Hold on. I'm gonna move there, and then he'll move there. And they move. So you can pause this in the middle of battle. Plan out your moves before you make them. Which is very, very handy. I like that in an RPG. So, where do I have to go now? The plot marker's down here now. Let's go. That was a dying cat or something. Oh, here we go.
Let go of me! Stop, please!
It's a party, isn't it? Grab a whore and have a good time.
What?
Savor the hunt, boys. Take this little elven wench here. So young and vulnerable.
Touch me and I'll gut you, you pig!
Please, my lord. We're celebrating weddings here.
Silence, worm!
Oh, shit.
I know what you're thinking, but maybe we shouldn't get involved.
Let's see, objection noted. Now let's get out of my way.
But let's try to be diplomatic, shall we?
Diplomatic.
What's this? The two grooms come to welcome me personally.
Human scum, you'll regret what you've done here.
Ha! Do you have any idea who I am?
knocked
Are you
the
insane?
Fuck out.
This is Barn Orion, the Isle of Denerim's son.
What? Oh, Maker.
Let's see. Maybe his father should have taught him better manners. Yeah.
You've a lot of nerve, Knife Ears.
Knife Ears.
This'll go badly for you.
We'll see about that.
Oh, I really messed up this time.
It'll be all right. He won't tell anyone an elven woman took him down.
I hope so. I should get cleaned up.
Is everybody else all right?
I think we're just shaken. What was that about?
Looks like the Jarl's son started drinking too early. Well, let's not let this ruin the day. This is Valora, my betrothed.
This beautiful vision must be Nisaria?
I am lucky to finally see you with my own eyes.
I'm sure the two of you have a lot to discuss.
Well, here we are. Are you nervous?
Yeah, I was until I saw you.
I'm speechless. I hope I'm worthy of your affection.
Come on, cousin. We should let them get ready.
We'll see you two in a bit. Don't disappear on us.
Or we'll hunt you down.
What?
Don't look now, but we have another problem.
I'm looking. What do you mean?
Another human just walked in. Could be one of Vaughn's or just a random troublemaker. Either way, we need to move him along before someone does something stupid.
Right. Let's go talk to him.
Let's do this quickly.
Where did Mr. Important-looking go? Oh, there he is. Duncan. What's going on, Duncan?
Good day. I understand congratulations are in order for your impending wedding.
Do you have business near you, human?
I do. I believe, however, that I may have already found what I was seeking.
And what might that be?
That is my business.
Leaving, I assume?
I'm sorry, but I have no intention of leaving.
Okay, maybe we can compromise.
He keeps his composure even when facing down an unknown and armed human. A true gift, wouldn't you say, Valendrian?
I would say the world has far more use of those who know how to stay their blades. It is good to see you again, my old friend. It has been far too long.
Okay, they know each other. Sorry, I had no idea.
I was hardly forthcoming, and for that I apologize.
May I present Duncan, head of the Grey Wardens in Ferelden.
Oh. Well met, Duncan.
And you, lad.
But my question remains unanswered. Why are you here, Duncan?
The worst has happened. A blight has begun. King Kaelin summons the Grey Wardens to Ostagar to fight the Darkspawn Horde alongside his armies.
Yes, I had heard the news. Still, this is an awkward time. There is to be a wedding, too, in fact.
So I see. By all means, attend to your ceremonies. My concerns can wait for now.
Very well. Children, treat Duncan as my guest. And for the Maker's sake, take your places.
Please, do not let me interrupt further. We shall speak more later.
Alright, so we've got a new codex entry for Duncan, new codex entry for the Grey Wardens, new codex entry for the Blight and Darkspawn. Get a ton of new screenshots. Alright, what do we have on the map here? A store. Gotta go talk to Valendrian. Let's go ahead and open our codex. magic and religion, the chant of light, the blight. No matter their power, their triumphs, the mage lords of Teventer were men, and doomed to die. Then a voice whispered within their hearts, shall you surrender your power to time like the beasts of the fields? You are the lords of the earth. Go forth to claim the empty throne of heaven and be gods. In secret they worked, magic upon magic, all their power and their vanity. They turned against the veil until at last it gave way. Above them a river of light, before them the throne of heaven waiting. Beneath their feet the footprints of the Maker, and all around them echoed a vast silence. But when they took a single step towards the empty throne, a great voice cried out, shaking the very foundations of heaven and earth. And so is the Golden City blackened. With each step you take in my hall, marvel at perfection, for it is fleeting. You have brought sin to heaven and doom upon all the world. Recognize that. Violently they were cast down, for no mortal man may walk boldly in the realm of dreams, bearing the mark of their crime, bodies so maimed and distorted that none should see them and know them for men. Deep into the earth they fled, away from the light. In darkness eternal they searched for those who had goaded them on, until at last they found their prize, their god, their betrayer, the sleeping dragon Doomat, their taint, twisted even the false god and the whisperer, awoke at last in pain and horror, and led them to wreak havoc upon all the nations of the world, the first blight. I've read that one. Venadol, the tree of the people, that was that tree we saw. Mostly the old ways are gone. Each generation forgets a little more of the old tongue, a little more of the traditions. And the few things we keep become simple habits, the meaning long since faded. So it is with the Venadol, the tree of the people. Every alienage has one, I'm told, or they used to. When I was a little girl, my mother told me that the tree was a symbol of Arlathan. But not even she knew more. Keeping the Venadol is just a habit now. Many cities have let theirs wither and die, then chop them off for firewood. No great loss. Grey Wardens. Bunch of stuff to read here. Look, like the lore. Alright. Whatever that was weird. The first blight had already raged for 90 years. The world was in chaos. A god had risen, twisted and corrupted. The remaining gods of Teventer were silent, withdrawn. What writing we have recovered from those times is filled with despair, for everyone believed, from the greatest archons to the lowliest slaves, that the world was coming to an end. At Weishaupt Fortress in the desolate Anderfels, a meeting transpired. Soldiers of the Imperium, seasoned veterans who had known nothing their entire lifetimes except hopeless war, came together. When they last left Weishaupt, they had renounced their oath to the Imperium. They were soldiers no longer, they were the Great Wardens. The Wardens began an aggressive campaign against the Blight, striking back the Darkspawn, reclaiming lands given up for loss. The Blight was far from over, but their victories brought notice, and soon they received aid from every nation in Thedas. They grew in number as well as reputation. Finally, in the year 992 of the Teventer Imperium, upon the Silent Plains, they met the Archdemon Doomat in battle. A third of all the armies of northern Thedas were lost to the fighting. But Doomat fell, and the Darkspawn fled back underground. Even that was not the end. The Imperium once revered seven gods: Doomat, Zazikul, Toth, Andoril, Razakael, Lusakan, and Uthermiel. Four have risen as archdemons. The Great Wardens have kept watch throughout the ages, well aware that peace is fleeting, and that their war continues until the last of the dragon gods is gone. We've got two new ones here, characters. One of them's Duncan. Men and women from every race, warriors and mages, barbarians and kings, the Grey Warden sacrificed everything to stem the tide of darkness and prevailed. Like many others, Duncan gave up his family name when he joined the ranks of the Wardens. A symbolic gesture of cutting ties. He might say this was a convenience in his case, however. His mother was from the Anderfels, his father from Teventer. His childhood was spent in the Free Marches and Orlais. His people were everywhere, and his homeland was nowhere. He was given the almost impossible task of leading the Wardens in Ferelden, a kingdom that had thrown the Order out about 200 years earlier. Facing local suspicion and hostility, he set about finding recruits. I'm going to butcher almost every name, pronunciation possible in this. Just a heads up. But, as R.A. Salvatore said himself, the way you pronounce something, a name, a location, a city, in a fantasy book or game, is just the way you pronounce it. That's in one of his interviews on YouTube. R.A. Salvatore is an amazing writer. Love his stuff, but he's got a point there. Especially, I mean, if you guys have read books before, you know that if you read a name in a book a certain way, and you read it that way throughout that entire book, and then you hear, like, somebody talk about the book and they say it completely differently than you've been pronouncing it that whole time, you're like, no, you're wrong. It's pronounced this way. That's just kind of the way it goes. Okay, so we've got a tooltip here for area map. The area map, M, displays a top-down view of your current area. Some regions will only be revealed when you explore them. By default, plot helpers are not shown in the unexplored regions, but you can change this out in the options menu. Controlling party members, we saw that. So, there's our map. And we will go ahead and move to the next plot marker, which is here. And apparently we're about to get married. Oh boy. Let's do this.
Oh, Soros. There you are. I was afraid you'd run off.
No, I'm here. Fellow groom in tow.
Good. I'm so pleased to finally do this.
I look worried.
It looks like everyone's ready.
I'm excited.
Perhaps it won't be so tragic after all.
Friends and family, today we celebrate not only this joining, but also our bonds of kin and kind. We are a free people. But that was not always so. Andraste, the Maker's prophet, freed us from the bonds of slavery. As our community grows, remember that our strength lies in commitment to tradition and to each other.
Thank you, Valendrian. Now let us begin. In the name of the Maker who brought us this world, and in whose name we say the Chant of Light, I...
Oh, okay. Oh,
my
no.
Lord, this is an unexpected surprise.
Sorry to interrupt, Mother, but I'm having a party, and we're dreadfully short of female guests.
Oh, this guy's an ass.
My Lord, this is a wedding!
If you want to dress up your pets and have tea parties, that's your business. But don't pretend this is a proper wedding. Now, we're here for a good time, aren't we, boys?
Just a good time with the ladies, that's all.
Let's take those two, the one in the tight dress, and where's the bitch that bottled me?
Over here, Lord Vaughn!
Let me go, you stuffed shirt son of a...
Oh, I'll enjoy taming her. And see the pretty bride.
What do we do?
Kill him? They're taking Shiani. Run, we've got to get out of here. You're a coward, I'll handle this.
Yes. The uppity runt that thinks he's worthy of speaking to me. Don't worry. I'll return whatever's left in time for the honeymoon.
I'll kill you.
I live in fear. Back to the palace, boys.
What? Really? Really?
Can you hear me, cousin? Are you all right?
Really? Do I look all right?
You took a hard headshot. You'll have to worry about that later, though.
Vaughn took Shiani, Nessiara, Valora, and the rest of the women in the wedding party back to the palace. The Elder is talking to Duncan, that Grey Warden. Everyone is getting upset.
Of course you're upset. I can't believe this.
Me neither. We should see if we can help. They're by the tree.
All right. By the tree. Tree's over here. Since we did read a bunch of stuff, and I'm about to read more stuff, I'll go ahead and read this codex entry. Then I think I will... Is this new? Give hands to the Maker. I think that's new. What else is new? That's new. Okay, since this video has been going on for a while, what I'll do is I'll cut this here. When I come back, I'll get into all the new codex entries, and then we'll go talk to Duncan, and hopefully we can go kill that guy that just stole my bride, because I already want to cut his head off. RPGs, man. They're intense. Until next time, guys, my name is Keizo. Take care.